Hello dear friends, today we are going to see one of the important topic from digital to analog converter. Topic name is binary weighted DAC. So as you know, digital to analog converter, they are popularly known as DACs. So we can say they are exactly opposite to analog to digital converters. So DACs, what DACs does, it convert the binary number, or we can say non-binary numbers and the codes, we can say digital codes, into analog ones. So this analog nothing but its output voltage, or we can say it is a current. So this analog voltage is nothing but proportional of the value of the digital input number. So we can say now, for example, if we have a 4-bit DAC, digital logic circuit, or we can say digital to analog converter circuit, that will range from 0000 to 1111. We can say in hexadecimal 0 to 15 means F16. So a DAC will convert that into analog voltage, and that will be range from 0 to 10. So this 0 to 10 depending upon the input voltage that we are going to feed when we are feeding zeros and 1 to DAC. Now, in case of analog to digital converter, what we are going to do, we are going to have n bit digital input code, and we are going to produce equivalent analog output from DAC. So that will be in between 0 to some Vmax value. So this Vmax value, we can say it is the value in which the zeros and ones are fed, or we can say the supply voltage that is also useful to calculate or to have analog output between 0 to Vmax value. So there are two ways, we can say there are two methods that are used in case of DACs. One method name is called binary weighted resistors using a summing amplifier, and there is a second method that is called as R2R resistor ladder network. So that is again going to use an operational amplifier for it. So these both ADC that are produced analog output with respect to digital input. We can see here a binary weighted D2A, and that is of 4 bit. So number of bit depending upon how number of or what number of digital input that we are connecting. So now we can see here we are connecting A, B, C and D, and that will have a range from binary 0000 to binary 1111. So that will correspond to decimal 0 to 15. So we can say in case of hexadecimal, it will be from 0 to F. So if we have to make DAC of 4-bit mode starting from 0000 to 1111, so we can have a weight of each input bit that is double with respect to the other. So we can say we have 8421 binary code. So look at here, 2 raised to 3, it is having a value called 8. 2 raised to 2, that is having a value called 4. 2 raised to 1, that is having a value 2. And this is 2 raised to 0, so something raised to 0 is equal to 1. So we can see here the VD, we can say MSB, that is equal to 2 raised to 3 or 2 raised to 3rd bit. This is having a binary weight 2 raised to 2. VB having a binary weight 2 raised to 1, and VA having a binary weight 2 raised to 0. So if we extend it for the, what we can say, 5 bit, 6 bit, the positional weight will be increased, like 2 raised to 4, 2 raised to 5 and so on. Now in case of DAC, 4-bit DAC, so we have input that is called as D input. So we can see here it is nothing but a VD. So it will have a resistance called 1K. If we go for the C input, we can say VC, the input resistance is 2K. If we go for VB, the input resistance is 4K. We go for VA, the input resistance is 8K. So we can say that the resistance is double at each position, starting from MSB to LSB. So LSB has 8 kilo ohm while MSB has 1 kilo ohm, where the feedback resistance is of 1 kilo ohm. Now, if we calculate the 4-bit binary weighted DAC's transfer characteristics, so we can see from here this simple, if we show this circuit is simply what we can say, it is a summing amplifier. Summing amplifier, where we can say the non-inverting terminal is connected to ground. Inverting terminal has a feedback resistor called 1 kilo ohm, and then there are inputs. So VD, VC, VB, VA, that will be sum, and the sum will be applied to this terminal core as inverting amplifier. So then finally we'll have a Vout, but that Vout will be minus. Why it is minus? Because all the input is connected to the inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. So you can see here the output is minus, and then if we look at here, the RF is 1 kilo ohm, so we can say the feedback resistance RF, and then we take one input by one, so we can see it is R4. So what will be the formula for it? RF upon R4. This is just a inverting amplifier's gain formula, RF upon R4 into VD. So for next, what it will be RF upon R3 VC, next it will be RF upon R2 VB, and next it will be RF upon R1 VA. So you can see here the RF is 1 kilo ohm, and from that circuit diagram you can see R4 is 1 kilo ohm, R3 is 2 kilo ohm, you can see here R2 is 4 kilo ohm again, and R1 is 8 kilo ohm. So if we take the calculations together, we can have 1 into VD as kilo ohm will get cancelled, 1 by 2 into VC, 1 by 4 into VB, and 1 by 8 into VA. So this will be the V out. So if we give VD, VC, VB, and VA, we'll have V out, and that will be a term called as analog. So if we give the readings like the first, that is DCBA, that is supposed to be 0, 0, 0, 0. So in that V out formula, all term will be calculated to be as 0. So you will have a 0 output in here. If we put it in here like 0, 0, 0, 1 in the next stage, what it will be? This is what we call 0 into 5, 0 into 5, 0 into 5, and 1 by 8 into 5. So why it is 1 by 8? Because the A terminal has 1 by 8 value. So you can see from that diagram here, the 1 by 8, that is nothing but the VA's value. So you can see here the reading comes, that is equal to 0.625. So now suppose we have a next 0010. So 1 by 4th reading will be there, and it will have a value minus 1.25. If we go like this 1, 1, there will be 1 by 4 into 5, 1 by 8 into 5. So this 5 is a logic 1, that is called as a plus 5 in case of a TTL logic. So this is minus 1.875, minus 2.50, minus 3.125 for 0100. For 0110, we'll have minus 3.75. As you can see, these two terminals are on. For this, we'll have this 3 to be on and this readings to be 0 for minus 4.375. So if we look at the last 1000, what we'll have? 1 into 5, that is the MSB. We can say this is a VD, and rest of the terms will be 000, we'll have a minus 5. If we proceed further for 1001, decimal 9, so in that the d is on, we can say, and the a is on in this formula. So we'll have minus 5.625 and so on. If you go at the last, when all terms are 1, 1, we can say it is a 15 or f, that is a hexadecimal f. So all will be on 1 into 5, 1 by 2 into 5, 1 by 4 into 5, 1 by 8 into 5. So we have finally minus 9.375. So you can see the result of the DAC is analog and it is going from 0 towards minus 9.375. So this is the result, that is for 0000 to 111. So in this way we have digital to analog converter, which will convert the digital numbers, or we can say codes, into analog values, we can say a voltage. So if we need, here is the operational amplifier, which will, this is a summing amplifier, and the output here is a negative. If we need a positive output, then connect another one, what we call as inverting amplifier in here. So its positive terminal is connected to ground, negative terminal having a feedback resistor, and that feedback resistor RF, and we have to connect one resistor over here, that resistor R1. So this RF, we can say RF1 is equal to R1, or we can say R11, they should be equal. So the gain will be 1, so that gain is actually minus 1, as minus RF1 upon R11, and then we'll have a positive output voltage. So if we need to convert that negative into positive, we need to go with this inverting amplifier with a gain of 1. So this is the way the DAC circuit is. The advantages of this particular DAC circuit is that in case of a construction, it is very simple. We can say it also provides the fast convergence. There are some disadvantage that what we need is that we need large range of resistors, like 1, 2, 4, 8. If you are using 8-bit DAC, what will have 1, 2, 4, 8, then next will be 16, 32, 64 and 128 kilo ohm. So if we proceed further for the what we can increase the bit, so it is very highly impossible to obtain all these resistors with necessary high precision. Okay, and then we require low switch resistance, or we can say switch resistance in transistors. So this is again one of the important factor in case of disadvantages. It will be expensive if we increase the number of bit, and the resolution should be limited to 8 bit size, so that we can have up to 28 kilo ohm resistor. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of the DACs. So thank you for listening my lecture patiently. Thank you.